What's it like being in Venice?
Huh? Well, I think it's wonderful, you know, to kiss butt wherever you can.
The king of comedy came ashore and met our Mark Steinitz at the Venice Film Festival. He was promoting The Truman Show, and the foreign press was swept away by the Carey charm.
I love you, Joaquin Carey. No matter what.
No, 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 I love you, no, no, no.
Jim had only been in Italy for a day, but was already acting like a local.
Uno solo, una leccacolo internazionale.
I have no idea what that
means. Ask him. Means I'm an international kiss.
The phenomenal success of The Truman Show already has Hollywood buzzing about a possible Best Actor nomination for its star.
What about the Oscar talk already? Does it got you hyped?
Oh, gosh, I don't concentrate on that, you know? I just move on. Back to the kitchen. Next meal.
That next meal is the big screen biography of late comedian Andy Kaufman. And Jim has grown out his hair and sideburns to resemble the former star of Taxi.
Man on the Moon.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fascinating. The lines are definitely getting blurred.
The eccentric Kaufman died of lung cancer in 1984. Time magazine reports this week that Jim has asked for two trailers on the set, one for himself and one for Kaufman's alter ego, a character named Tony Clifton.
Tony Clifton is a lounge lizardy type character that Andy Kaufman created as a joke. And rumor has it that even when he's in character, he asks people to call him Tony or to call him Andy. He never gets called Jim at all, from what we hear.
E.T. did an interview with Kaufman in 1982 when he tangled with a pro wrestler.
The business that I think I'm in is breaking boundaries.
While stories about his antics from Man on the Moon continue to swirl, Jim told us he is indeed bulking up for the role.
I hope to eat some good stuff.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You're a big pasta fan?
I need to put on a little weight for Andy.